This, folks, this could be nasty. The last time we saw these two across from each other in the ring, it was violent.
And it was because of the staff in that man's hand. He is from the borderlands, the Battle King, Dave Dutra.
That staff in Dave Dutra's right hand was used in a way to render Scoot Robertson unconscious. And when he hit him upside the head with it, that's all she wrote. And Scoot Robertson went down for the count. And we've seen Dutra on many occasions in the PPW ring, but this new persona of the Battle King that he's adopted in the last year or so, the veteran
and his
here
opponent
in the Bay Area, has turned himself into one of the more despised men here in the Phoenix Theater, and he's calling out Scoot. He has a staff in one hand, and he has that gauntlet that he just threw aside in the other. And here comes a man, the last winner of the Kyle Cup Battle Royal.
Fighting out of the Nabuki Khan Dojo, representing the Honor Society, weighing in at 335 pounds, Scoot Robertson.
Scoot Robertson, on a couple of different occasions, has come very close to becoming PPW champion. He did win that Battle Royal. In fact, he threw Dave Dutra over the top to win that Battle Royal. Dutra, he took exception to that, hence why he used that staff to win their match in December. But tonight, in this no-holds-barred match, Scoot Robertson, as you can see, is not dressed to wrestle. He is dressed to fight. And this crowd, which has always been behind this man who used to be, he called him the young boy at one point of the Honor Society, but he is no longer that young boy. If anything, he's become one of the most beloved men in Phoenix Pro Wrestling. And you hear Dutra, he was smacking that staff against the post, and there is the equalizer for Scoot Robertson. The staff for Dutra, and a steel chair, one of the Phoenix Theater's finest, for Scoot Robertson. And Corey, the referee here, is gonna have himself, he's gonna have a difficult time. Remember, no holds barred. It can go all over the ring, no disqualifications. Pinfall or submission only, and they swing. Staff meets chair, and the staff is out of Dutra's hand. But he ducks that swing of the chair and sends Scoot in. Oh, and he kicks the chair out of Dutra's hand. Spinebuster! And Scoot Robertson is not wasting any time. Before the show got started tonight, they presented the Kyle Cup Trophy. Scoot Robertson won that back in March of 2020. That seems so long ago. Dutra, though, pounding away in the corner on Robertson. Robertson trying to cover up. But instead, he's got Dutra up. Might be a powerbomb situation here. That sits him out. Cover two and only two. And on that night, Robertson earned entry into a triple threat match for the PPW Championship. It was Jacob Fatu defending against Robertson and Boyce LeGrand. Of course, LeGrand won the title that night, pinning Robertson. And ever since then, there have been a lot of people wondering if Robertson was ever going to get another shot at the title as they go to the outside. And now Dutra trying to reverse Scoot and now sending him into the post. We knew Steele was going to get involved at some point. And this crowd that is filled in nicely here at the Phoenix Theater will have to be very cautious. And he's sent in to the steel guardrail. There is security at ringside. And they're going to, oh, look at this. Dutra, he took off the guardrail from its hinge and is slamming it down on the sternum and face of Scoot Robertson. Robertson even teased that that balcony doesn't look too high. And folks, I would not put it past him to do it. And they are into the crowd. Dutra with a big right hand. I'm going to have to stand up here. Dutra with a chop up against one of the stairwells here. And Robertson returns fire. We have seen matches before go all over the Phoenix Theater. In fact, one of the more memorable ones, and the late, great Virgil Flynn was part of that match. Went into the bathroom upstairs at the Phoenix Theater even, as they now go all the way across onto the west side of the building. Now, there are skate ramps on either side when the ring is not here. This is kind of an after-school area, and they're on to kind of some of the staging over on that side, that wooden staging, and that's what Dutra's on right now after he threw Scoot onto it, and they're up to the top of it. What does Dutra have in mind here? No, he's thinking about suplexing him off it. Oh, my God. No. There are fans that were on the land. They were going to be in the way. Dutra. Oh, a pile driver? Are you kidding me? No, Scoot! Ah, back body drop! And you can hear the thud all the way across the theater, reverberating in the hall. And Scoot Robertson, this is not the only time that a member of the Honor Society has been in a street fight. Sir Samurai took on Joe DeSole in a street fight. As he's sending Scoot Dutra into the wall of the Phoenix Theater. Multiple times. Into that cement wall. Robertson in that headlock, taking him back towards ringside. Into the guardrail. Now, this is not a falls count anywhere match, I don't believe. The pinfall has to come in the ring, but the reason why they're out there now is because they want to use everything to their advantage as he Dutra down the quarter pipe. He's gonna send him skateboarding, I think is what Scoot said, and second time down the quarter pipe for Dutra. And a third time. He's counting them out. I think that's three. Ducking one. Dutra, a boot. He's going to go up the corner. Pipe! And a swinging DDT! Normally, when he's inside the ring, he goes off the ropes. But he vaults off the quarter pipe that time, and that is wooden floor, that hardwood floor. And now he has some of that paneling, and he slams it down on top of Scoop. And he's going to bring that into the ring now. Scoop was in control after that back body drop, but Dutra found his opening. As he sends Scoot in the guardrail, and the guardrail hit the ring. And that second piece of particle board goes back into the ring. And it kind of splinters as it gets thrown in. And Dutra puts Scoot back in. So as we mentioned, while it is a no-holds-barred match, they do have to count the pinfall in the ring. Now Dutra has that chair that Scoot introduced as the equalizer to that staff that Dutra has right to the small of the back. And now that particle board. Dutra, I think he's trying to figure out some way to maybe wedge it in against the turnbuckles there. He just has it resting up there now. Lays the other one down across that bottom turnbuckle. And Scoot back to his feet, swinging around. Big right hands. And now Dutra trying to stop himself from going into the particle board. Scoot's shot ducked. Dutra waistlock, Saito suplex, got it. Robertson over by that chair. He's got both hands on it, but Dutra, with his senses about him, trying to wrest it away, and look at that. Totally legal, totally legal. In fact, Corey's asking him. That is a situation where if Scoot wanted to, he could have given up. That was well within the bounds of this match. But Dutra wants to inflict more punishment. And this stage, folks, this might be the hardest spot for Dutra to inflict damage in this entire building. But Dutra has other ideas. He's going to bring him back in. He wants to try and win this match, I think. Maybe a suplex. He's looking for that swinging net breaker. He's looking to go into the particle board. Oh my God! Scoot's neck right on the corner of that particle board. Dutra trying to make it two in a row over Scoot Robertson, but Robertson gets the shoulder up. Dutra has many ways to try and take down his opponent as he sends Scoot outside. We've seen him win the last match with that elbow drop after the staff shot, and he has the staff in hand. He knows that's what led him to victory last time, and he might be looking for an encore as Scoot is trying to pull himself up. And there's a staff shot right between the shoulder blades. And we're back up on the stage. There are children up on the speakers, and they thought they were in a safe spot in a knee shot by Dutra. And they're back over there by that quarter pipe. Oh, and he sends them into the speaker. Karina Kyle is also out there, senior official for PPW, to assist, along with security. They are making sure every safety measure is procured for the fans here at ringside, while also making sure that what little rules of this match are abided by the wrestlers. And you can hear Dutra saying, "Who's the king?" But Scoot with a super kick. And Scoot, he's looking to the speakers. No, 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 no. Well, it's not the balcony, but if he's thinking what I think he's thinking, this man who's about as big a daredevil as there could be, no, he is. He is going to the top of that speaker. The crowd has seen this before. Whether it be the top rope to the floor, the cage to the floor, Scoot Robertson taking all the risks. He's gonna fly! One of the damnedest things you'll see in the Phoenix Theater. And a primal scream from Scoot Robertson. The Battle King wiped out by one of the biggest chances you'll see here in PPW. Scoot bringing him back to the ring to try and finish this off. That chair into the ring. And that's where Scoot is going. He signaled that that's what he wanted to use symbolically to get back at Dutra's use for the staff in the December match. And he connects square in the back with that chair shot. And now sits the chair down. Scoot Robertson, that was a hard shot. You could hear the thud from here. Scoot going, he's going back under the ring. What more could he have in mind? And he's got more chairs. We've seen him take the biggest risk in this match. The moonsault off the speaker has sent Dave Dutra into a stupor. And now, Scoot Robertson could be looking to powerbomb him through these chairs, trying to finish this off. He's got him up. Dutra punching his way out. Now biting his way out, and still biting his way out. Forearm shot, and a second one, and a super kick. And now that Death Valley driver, he's trying to maybe go through the chairs. Has him up, he does! Scoot Robertson wanted to finish it once and for all, but Dutra turns the tables on Robertson, and he might be looking to cement his place as the owner of Robertson in PPW. And now that chair that began this match is set back up. And now you can see what Dutra is thinking. Those elbows to the back of the head, right into the chair. He's thinking of finishing him off just like he did in December. That elbow drop was what led to the pinfall, and now he's trying to elbow drop him through the chair. Dutra perched, leaps, pulled away. Robertson has the chair, throws it right into Dutra's face. Dutra picks it up, throws it right back into Robertson's face. I'm not sure how much Dutra had behind it, though. Tornado kick! The chair right back into Dutra's face, and now Robertson spearing Dutra into that particle board. Robertson to the top. He might be looking to get froggy. All of it. Cover, hook of the leg, and we have a winner.
Your winner, Scoot Robertson.
Scoot knew something that Dave Dutra didn't coming into this match. He knew when and where to take the biggest chances. The biggest chance in this match was taken by Scoot Robertson. And yes, Dutra did his damnedest to try and return Molly. But in the end, he just could not keep up with the risks that Scoot Robertson was willing to take to win. There were measured ways the Battle King was trying to prove a point with the staff, with the chair shots, trying to finish him with that elbow through the chair. But in the end, Scoot Robertson, that final flurry, picks up the victory, gets his revenge, and might be back on the path to what thinks is rightfully his. He won the Kyle Cup in 2020. He was so close to winning the PPW title. And now, after getting in the way, Dave Dutra, at least in Scoot's eyes, has been vanquished. Could the PPW Championship be in Scoot's future? This crowd hopes so. And the smile. Scoot Robertson knows what he had to do to get a win tonight. And he got every bit of that earned victory with all the risks he had to take. A final bow to the faithful here. A point to the victory. And a winner is Scoot Robertson.